All right, this is fourth grade, module 5, lesson 2. And in this lesson, students are going to be decomposing fractions as a sum of unit fractions. And they're going to be modeling that using tape diagrams and number bonds. And the idea of this is, you know, we want students to be able to visualize 3/4, for example, as 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4. And sometimes it's going to help them to think of it as a number bond. Sometimes it's going to help them to think of it as a tape diagram. Sometimes it's just going to be helpful for them to think of it as a sum of 3 unit fractions. And so that's what this lesson is about. It's not really leading towards any particular standard algorithm at this point. At this point, we're just really building understanding of fractions for our students. We don't want students to be thinking of fractions as some sort of mysterious thing to avoid. Instead, we want them to understand that fractions are numbers and they make sense and they're kind of fun, really. So let's get started on this. So the idea on this problem is we are supposed to do 3 things. First, we're going to draw and shade a tape diagram. Then we're going to record the decomposition as a sum of unit fractions, and then record the decomposition in 2 different ways, right? So the first thing is, well, what are unit fractions? And just as a recap, unit fractions are fractions where the numerator is a 1. So these are 2 examples up here of unit fractions. For example, here's 5/6. Here's a picture of 5/6. Here it is as a sum of unit fractions, and here is 5/6 in 2 different ways of decomposition without using necessarily all unit fractions. So for 7/10. So what is 7/10 going to look like? Well, we're going to start with a bar of any length. And we know because the denominator is a 10, we're going to cut it up into 10 equal-sized pieces. Let's label this entire thing 1. And then we want to shade in 7 of those 10 little pieces. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And so there is our drawing. So we've done step 1. Woohoo! We've drawn it. Now the idea is record it as a sum of unit fractions. So 7/10 is going to be 1/10 plus 1/10 plus 1/10 plus 1/10. Oh my goodness. Plus 1/10 plus 1/10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 plus 1 more 10th. So there's our 7/10. As a sum of unit fractions. And now our job is to show it in 2 other ways. Oh, so I'm just going to kind of cheat here. I'm going to say, okay, how about 3/10 plus 4/10? And then let's do, 2/10 plus 4/10 plus 1/10. So there you go. In fact, there's a ton of different ways that students can do it. And for your real high-flying kids, a really neat lesson, a neat activity would be give them something with a small numerator, some sort of fraction with a small numerator. Oh, let's say 3/7. It doesn't really matter as long as that numerator is pretty small. And tell them, come up with all of the different ways that you can make 3/7 using nothing but addition. So there's going to be lots of ways. 2/7 plus 1/7. And then in this case, you might argue whether 1/7 plus 2/7 is something different. And the idea is come up with all the different ways to create that fraction. Keeping in mind, you need to use a fairly small numerator, maybe something 7 or smaller. And your high-flying students are going to love this. This math is called combinatorics. Combinatorics. And it's really just kind of fun. Fun way to make math, engaging a little bit. So we're going to do more of the same. Here we have to draw and then record the decomposition in 3 different ways. So we're going to begin by drawing our bar, and I just made it long for no particular reason. And this whole bar represents 1, And then we're going to cut it into 12 pieces. So I'm going to begin by cutting it into 4 pieces. And because 4 times 3 is 12, I'm going to cut each one of those into 3 pieces. So 4 times 3 is 12. And now I know I have 12 pieces. And the numerator is a 10, so I need to shade in 10 of those 12 pieces, which means I'm not going to shade in 2. There we go. And so there is our picture of 10 twelfths. And then there's a whole ton of ways that you can write, decompose that as a sum of a variety of different fractions, right? So you could do 5 twelfths plus 5 twelfths. Let's see, 10 twelfths could be 3 twelfths plus 3 twelfths. Gee whiz, why do I keep putting a 10 here? Plus 3 twelfths plus 1 twelfth. And you get the idea. There's just a ton of different options. Parents and teachers, feel free to differentiate this by allowing your students to try and find all the possible ways to create 10 twelfths. It's a really engaging problem. Some beautiful patterns show up during that hunt as you're looking for all the possible ways rather than just 3. And the last slide for this video, just more of the same. Now, the idea might be, why are we going through this rigmarole? Why are we going through this hassle? And the idea is because we want students to learn how to visualize fractions. So when we're drawing 6/5, we want students to visualize this as something that's going to be larger than 1 because, let's see, I'm going to start by drawing 6 pieces. So there are our 6 pieces because the numerator says 6. Now that 5 is the denominator, meaning one whole is going to be right here after 5 pieces. So those 5 pieces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, those 5 little unit pieces represents the one whole, plus we have that extra 5th right here. So that's our 6/5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we want students to really not just rote memorize, oh, if the numerator is bigger than the denominator, then it's more than 1. We want students to have an understanding of why, and that's what this is about. And then once you've drawn the picture, 6/5 can be done a whole variety of ways. Most importantly, probably 5/5 plus 1/5, because that tells us that's equal to 1 1/5. Right? So we're doing a little bit of foreshadowing of how to turn an improper fraction into a mixed number. And this is another example right here of why that makes sense. So if we're going to draw 1 whole and 1/4, the idea is, well, here's 1 whole, and that whole must be cut into fourths. Why is it cut into fourths? Because this other fraction here says so. So this whole right here is our picture. Now we need to draw 1/4 more, because that's what this 1/4 is. So here's our 1 whole, and here's our 1/4, and there's our picture. And we can see that we now have 5/4. Because another way to think of this is 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4. In fact, that is one of our sums that we can decompose and write as a sum. There you go. And then another one, 1 1/4. Oh, we could do 3/4 plus 2/4. And there's a ton of different options. And that wraps up fourth grade module 5, lesson 2, where students are visualizing fractions using tape diagrams, and then they're writing it in a variety of decompositions.